you know, when I went to Delia's archive when it was donated in 2007 to Manchester University, it was like, yeah, here is a story. There is the most amazing story here. You've got this incredible sound. You've got these sort of beautiful, her notes and her papers and these sort of really beautiful glimpses into Delia's life. There's a sense that she was also a very private person. And so the idea of, you know, prying into her life felt like it was something I had to be very mindful and careful about. You know, what did she want us to know? I was asking myself that question all the time. And in the end, I sort of came up with the answer. For me, the answer seemed to be, she wants us to know about her music. This is what really gives us access. So that was great because it gave me this sort of poetic license and my imagination runs wild and, you know, you have these facts and you have the other facts. And then I just thought, I don't want to tell a biopic. This is going to be a very subjective piece through my imagination, reaching out to Delia across eras, through cozy sound as well. But we need to have these things backed up with the best evidence that we have. And the best evidence that we have, apart from her box of 1,000 papers, were memories, the memories of her friends and her colleagues. And that became a very important part. We needed to have anchors, I felt, anchors into something that was very much Delia's real world. So that's kind of what made me want to do that.